mean, there's so many things in the world that can be improved. Just think of it. Moving sidewalks, flying cars. The possibilities are endless.
Flying cars. Yeah, that's a good one.
All it takes is some imagination and a little science, and we can make the world a better place.
Well, these are all interesting ideas. So, what's your favorite sport?
Well, does inventing count as a sport?
Actually...
because I think I hit a home run with this one.
What is that?
First, a question. What's the number one problem that you face when you make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich?
Lewis, I don't think we...
Portion control. Too much peanut butter sticks through your mouth. Takes forever to chew. Too much jelly squishes out the sides and makes your hands all sticky. Blech. Well, I propose that the perfect PB&J is within mankind's grasp. And I've built this machine to achieve it. For this demonstration, I'll use regular bread.
Honey, it's okay.
As you can see, toasting is an option.
We don't usually eat peanut butter.
Lewis, this is really not necessary.
It's jammed!
Lewis, please don't!
Oops. What's happening?
Mr. Harrington has a peanut allergy.
Ah! Sorry! Here, let me help you get that off!
Stand back!
Is it gonna be okay?
Breathe. Breathe.
I'm so sorry, I didn't know.
It was really nice to meet you. We're gonna need some time to think about it.
Hi, folks. Everything all right?
What happened?
Miss Duffy, that boy is definitely not right for us. Now, if you'll excuse me.
I'm so sorry about this. If you would just...
I made some lunch.
Not hungry.
Poor Mr. Harrington.
I killed him?
No. You didn't kill him. I called. He's perfectly fine. I was just gonna say that it's too bad he didn't get to try a sandwich from that wonderful invention of yours.
Yeah, real wonderful.
It's not you. We just haven't found the right couple yet.
124.
What?
That's how many adoption interviews I've had. 124.
Oh, Lewis, come on now. You're exaggerating just to make your point.
Plus, I'm gonna be 13 next year, and you know how hard it is for a teenager to get adopted. I have no future. No one wants me.
That's not true, Lewis.
My own mother didn't even want me.
Now stop it. You do not know that.
Then why'd she give me up?
She may not have been able to take care of you. Did you ever think of that? I am sure that she was only thinking about what was best for you.
I never thought of it that way.
Maybe she wanted to keep you, but she had no choice.
You're right. My real mom is the only person who's ever wanted me.
Wait, I said maybe.
And if she wanted me then, she'll want me now.
What are you talking about?
I have to find her, Mildred. And when I do, she'll take me back. And we'll be a family again.
You can't do that. No one knows anything about her. No one even saw her.
Wrong. I saw her. Once. She's in here. I just have to remember.